Yo, yo, people, welcome back to The Noise the King Boss. And today we're going to be looking at Loki, Season 1, Episode 3. Let's jump into this one. So moving forward, I won't really be giving you guys, let's say, a breakdown of the episode, because I do think most people would have watched it already, or most people do want to watch it, so I won't be giving any spoilers. What I will be doing is just pointing out things that I might have picked up on, and then at the very end, I'm going to give you my thoughts on what's happening next. Now, the thoughts on what might be happening next might be completely different from the previous episode, obviously, because they might be introducing new things that I've seen now, or my views simply might change. All right, so let's make a start. All right, so first thing first, we found out in this episode that the female version of Loki, whatever she calls herself, I think it's Sylvia or Sylvie, she actually has this ability to invade people's memories and plant herself there. So it's quite a nice trick, because what she's been doing to that person she kidnapped in the previous episode, she's been going into her memory, trying to figure out information about the TVA. Nice addition to her power sets, I guess, because another thing noticed from this episode is that female and male Loki, even though they're the same person from an alternate dimension, they have different power sets. For example, male Loki was trained by his mother, which is obviously Thor's mom as well, but female Loki had to teach herself all this stuff. One other semi-important fact we found out about both Lokis is that they're both bi. Now, I'm not going to use the entire word, but yeah, they're both bi. It's not something for me that added or took anything away from the characters themselves. And because of that, that added information to me was pointless. But again, we haven't seen the full story yet. We don't know if that's going to become important later on. But the conversation they were having at the time when it was really revealed by both of them, I guess it made sense within the context of that conversation. But again, for me, it added nothing to the story. But yeah, they're bi. Now, the biggest reveal in this episode, well, this was a big show reveal, actually. And I'm thinking about it. It came really early in the series. This is only episode 3 of, I believe, 10 episodes. And they're already revealing stuff this big, all right? So the TVA doesn't actually create anyone. So I remember Agent Mobius saying everyone at the TVA was created by the Time Lords or something like that, or the Time Lizards or whatever they're called, right? But we found out that in this episode that's not true. And this came to us in two versions, right? The lady who Lady Loki kidnapped in the previous episode and she was in her memories, she wouldn't have memories of a previous life if she was created for the TVA. And also, Lady Loki came out and said, well, everyone at the TVA, they're variants. They just had their memories wiped. Now, this was a big reveal in my opinion. I did have kind of a suspicion that this was the case, because this TVA, they're creating humans now. I mean, that would have been a bit weird, because there was no indication at any point in time that the people Loki was interacting with, the people at the TVA, were not humans. So I made the assumption that they were humans. And as such, how could these Time Lords or Time Lizards or whatever they are create humans, right? But yeah, I kind of had an idea that that's what was happening. This also flips the whole theory of the TVA being the good guys and this Loki being the bad guy on his head. Now, if they're kidnapping variants and wiping out universes and wiping memories and lying to people, again, as I said in my previous episode, that doesn't really sound like someone or a group of people who are the good guys. That sounds like the bad guys to me. And I think, again, the TVA is going to slowly be revealed to be the bad guys. And maybe through some way, female Loki is going to maybe unlock the memories of other people higher up in the TVA, and that's what's going to start the revolution, let's say. That's what I'm thinking. That's what I'm hoping for, because that's what I see logically happening here. Now, in terms of the two Lokis, I do like how they had to work together to get on the train. So one Loki's method wasn't sufficient to get on the train, so they both had to do a bit. I like how they interact with each other. The moments between them are actually really funny, or they're really emotional. For example, it was really funny when they're on the train having those conversations. It was really funny when they both got blasted by that lady in the beginning of the episode. It was really emotional, when they got kicked off the train and they were just having that conversation about what's next and how do they actually get off the planet. I've been saying this since episode one. I do believe that this series is going to be this version of Loki's fast track to redemption, to being back to the Loki that we know. Because please do remember that this Loki that we see here, it was only a few days or weeks maybe ago that he was actually the Loki that invaded New York in 2012. However, this is the same Loki now, seeing his mother die, seeing his father die, seeing him reconcile with his brother. He's being thrusted forward into being a good guy again, because at that time he was genuinely a bad guy. But I do love, as I said, the interaction between them. I think it's different, it's unique. I do get the sense that they flirt with each other a bit, but I also get the sense that it probably wouldn't go there. I do get the sense that they feel like the same person. Their wit and their banter is very similar. Another thing that happened here was Loki was actually drinking. Male Loki was drinking and having fun while female Loki was passed out. He, I guess, somehow found a way to chat to the locals and befriended them, and they all started drinking and dancing. Not something you've really seen of Loki before, other than in one of the Thor movies, I believe, where Loki was mimicking being Odin, and they had that mini party stroke theater event. Other than that, pretty straightforward episode. The story did move along quite slowly, but I think the main purpose of this episode was to show the interaction between these two, because there's either going to be a lot of interaction coming in the future, or these two are going to be working closely together. There's going to be something obviously important happening with these two, so building that relationship with them, making them have that bond from now on, it does make sense. It did feel a bit slow overall, but the big reveal was necessary. The interaction between them was also necessary. Alright, well, I do want to thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. Do please comment, like, subscribe, share. Just do the whole thing, alright? Peace.